हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 627 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स ऑफ कोरिएंडर, पॉपुलरली नोन एज धनिया। एंड द ओरिजिन ऑफ कोरिएंडर गोज टू साउथ यूरोप। फ्रॉम साउथ यूरोप इट केम टू नॉर्थ अफ्रीका एंड देन वेस्ट एशिया। But today, coriander is globally popular and one of the super spice. Its seed as well as green leaves. And in India, actually, all the preparations, whether it is any meat, fish, curry, vegetable, at the end, we are adding the raw small pieces of green leaves, and that hot preparation before eating it, it gives very good fragrance and it stimulates and it refreshes our mood. So the green leaves are widely used in Indian subcontinent in raw form, and this coriander, dhania, is very rich in volatile essential oil, and these volatile essential oils, they are nothing but the mixture of terpenes. And here the one terpene which is known as linalool, and this linalool is 90% found in coriander, and in the rest of the 10%, that volatile essential oil is your pinene, and it may be alpha beta isomeric form pinene. Then geraniol is also isomeric form of citral, and in Indian dhania coriander, thymol is also present, and it also contains one aldehydic compound. Also it contains paracyamine. So in this way, lot of mixture of terpenes are there, and apart from terpenes, it also contains lot of other phytochemicals, and they are vitamin A, it is rich in beta carotene, vitamin C, and B9, that is folic acid, folate, which is also very important for our immune system and especially for our respiratory system. It is also rich in linoleic acid. So overall, it is a very good antioxidant as well as anti-inflammatory. It has lot of health benefits. It is useful in cough and bronchitis and cold. It is good for our hair growth and also for skin disease like eczema or skin irritation. Actually, this coriander seed oil is very good smell. It is having very good smell and fragrance, and because of that reason, long ago it was used as a perfume. But today, the essential oil of coriander is mixed with some other fragrance, and it is also served as a perfume. And in this coriander, the presence of geraniol, this structure, I mean, that is responsible of this one. This is responsible of giving very good fragrance or perfumery smell. And this coriander is having 90% linalool. Linalool is hydrocarbon terpene, and this is the structure of linalool. So your dhania, whether it is leaf or seed, is 90% this volatile essential oil, and rest of the other 10% are paracyamine, then pinene can be in alpha and beta isomeric form, then geraniol, and also in Indian coriander, we have isolated thymol also, and recently another aldehyde aldehyde compound is isolated, that is called tri decinal. Decinal AL means aldehyde. So 9, this it is 10. So tri decinal aldehyde, and that is the part of our essential oil. This is also containing borneol, and that is monoterpene. So these are all the constituents of our volatile terpene mixture of dhania. So now let me tell you some very important health benefit and some medicinal value of coriander seeds as well as green leaves. Coriander seeds, they are very effective to our skin, acne, irritation. It also brings down the glycemic index, so indirectly it helps in diabetic condition. It also improves the hair growth, and it is very good and effective in irregular menstrual cycle, because it can activate the endocrine gland, and that endocrine gland is directly responsible for maintaining the normal menstrual cycle. So these are all very, very important health benefits. And this one, this coriander, the botanical name of coriander, that is dhania, is Coriandrum sativum Linn. And it belongs to family Umbelliferae. Number one, it is extensively used in India and popularly known as dhania. I have already mentioned, but I am again going to give you in writing form and some more explanation. And that is called dhania. It contains essential volatile oil, that is up to 1%, and that 1% volatile oil constitute of linalool. Linalool is hydrocarbon terpene, and that is the constituent of 90%. 90 in dhania, I mean coriander, 90% is linalool volatile oil, and in rest of the 10%, the other terpene constituents are pinene, thymine, thymol, borneol and geraniol, and all structures I have already given. Number two, it is mainly used as an aromatic carminative. Aromatic carminative means it is very effective to gastric problem. So that is called carminative effect, and it is very good flavoring agent. The volatile oil of coriander is one of the constituent in aromatic elixir. Actually, elixir is a very old traditional perfume. So, coriander essential oil was the main constituent of that, we can say, preparation, that is, elixir is the oldest perfume. So, in oldest perfume, the extract of essential oil of coriander, dhania, was there. So, it is also used as a perfume, because it contains very important, we can say, perfumery compound terpene, that is called geraniol, and that geraniol is the isomeric form of citral, and citral is actually perfume that is found in lemongrass oil. We have already discussed that one. So, and that is dhania is super spice in various health benefits. It is used to flavor curries, meat, stew, vegetable, fish, many dishes. And green dhania leaves are added to these dishes in raw form before use. And the heat of serving dishes tend to have very good fragrance. Actually, before taking all those very good dishes, especially in curries, stews, in fish stews, the green raw dhania leaves are added, and that is going to stimulate the mood. At the same time, it will I had very good fragrance, mood booster. And then number three, it is good for skin health. Seeds are quite effective in curing different skin ailments like eczema, itchy skin, and it has antiseptic and anti-inflammatory effect because of the presence of linoleic acid, and not only linoleic acid, some vitamins are also there like vitamin C, vitamin A, vitamin B9, that is folate, and carotene, and it is also having phosphorus and calcium. So it has antiseptic effect, anti-inflammatory effect because of the presence of linoleic acid. It is a cure for cold and flu because of the presence of lot of vitamins, and it is also helpful in diabetic condition. So it can bring down the glycemic index of the body, means that it will allow lot of time to get broken down all the carbohydrate into free glucose. And once a lot of time is taken, then the glycemic index will be low. So it helps in diabetes, help to lower the glycemic index. Foliates, hair growth, it also help in foliate hair growth, and good for digestion because it is rich in fiber. It prevents menstrual irregular cycle because of the presence of all these phytochemicals, and these phytochemicals can stimulate the endocrine gland, and that endocrine gland is responsible of maintaining the normal menstrual cycle. Actually, in India, जब हम लोग स्टू या फिश का बेहतरीन कड़ी या कोरमा खाते हैं और उसमें हरी धनिया पड़ जाए तो इट इज रियली फंटास्टिक. सो रियली इट इज अ वेरी गुड टू हैव वेरी गुड फ्लेवर ऑफ आवर ऑल टाइप ऑफ करी एंड स्टू. So go on using coriander, dhaniya, green leaves. It is very much helpful. Also the seeds. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.